Here we are at Landfall with Eric Magnuson, our frostbiting specialist. He's going to talk to you guys today about gloves.
So what I have here first is the normal sailing glove. It's got three fingers covered and two fingers exposed. The fabric on this is really not going to serve to keep you warm. All it's going to do is keep that icy cold water that you're dealing with trapped close to your skin. It's not very helpful. The lightest weight of the gloves I have is the Gill Three Season Glove. It's neoprene on the top, which is a good insulator and works even when it's wet. And it's just your normal sailing palm on the inside, so it's going to be able to grip the line. The nice thing about this glove is that it is not very cumbersome. It's easy to grip the line, easy to move. Moving up the warmth scale, we have the Gill Extreme Glove. This is still a neoprene glove, although it is fully neoprene on both sides. It's also insulated with a little bit of a thinsulate liner, just like a winter glove. Still going to work when wet, still not going to keep your hand entirely dry, but it's a little bit warmer than the Three Season. Moving up, we have the first fully waterproof glove. This is the Atlas Temrez glove. It's made out of a rubber, so it's completely waterproof, but the rubber is thin enough that it's actually breathable, so your hand, if it's wet, can dry out. The rubber is fairly thin, so it's still kind of easy to grip the line, but because you have this fuzzy acrylic liner on the inside, it does add a little bit of bulk to the glove. Next on up, we have the Gill Winter Glove. This is a full neoprene glove with waterproof seams. You can see here that the seams have been glued, so water is not going to get through any of these seams. The only way water is getting into the glove is through the wrist. Being fully neoprene and a thicker neoprene than the Three Season glove, it is a bit more cumbersome though. The next one we have is the NRS Reactor Rescue Glove. This one is like the Gill in that it's a full neoprene glove, pretty thick, still waterproof seams, taped and glued, so it's not going to let any water in except for the wrist. Unlike the Gill, the wrist is a little bit more open, so it is easier to get your hand in there, but you do have a Velcro, which is going to tighten the wrist and help keep water from getting in. The fingers are pre-curved so that you don't waste your energy squeezing the glove from straight to curved most of the time you're going to be holding a glove. The other really, really nice thing is this fuzzy patch right here. We all know that when you're sailing in freezing cold weather, your nose runs. It's a fact of life. This is for wiping your nose, and I use it all the time. The warmest glove we have, I would not really recommend for sailing. This is more of a race committee or a coaching glove. It's the Gill Helmsman glove, and it is water resistant, not waterproof by any means, but if you need to reach your hand in the water real quick to pick up a mark, you'll be fine. So if you're running race committee on those frostbiting days or you're coaching early in the spring, this is a great glove for you, but not for sailors. All right.